Just wanted to ask you first about your experience with working on Superman 2. And just...
That's an original question. Is that the best you can do?
For now.
Well, where do you start with your experiences on Superman 2? I mean, it's a, you know, it was an enormous project. And which bit of Superman 2 are we talking about?
The scenes toward the end of the movie, the final fight scene in the Fortress of Solitude.
But are you talking about when I did it with Richard Donner? You're the Superman expert. Well, Richard Lester.
Well, Richard Donner and Richard Lester. You can tell us a little bit about both of them.
First and foremost, I remember very little. Okay. Because it was 1,000 years ago, as we probably recall. As far as the, obviously I remember the distinctions, the differences between Donner and Lester, which were, without doubt, Richard Donner, who originated, was our first director, was a very laid-back LA kind of a guy, with his blue-tinted glasses, and very cool and very relaxed. Richard Lester was a rather prim and proper Englishman, with not, for a gentleman that directs a lot of comedy-type things, has, I wouldn't say was with a lot of humour. Very straight, very proper. So their approaches to directing were completely different. Richard Donner was very laid-back. You come in, Sarah, you do this, you pick this guy up, you throw him over your shoulder, and if you can't get it in the first shot, it doesn't matter. We've got plenty of days to shoot it in. So his manner was much less controlled. Richard Lester, and for instance, the sequence where I... it's a good sound. Richard Lester, the sequence where I'm throwing the manhole cover. We got to that at about, I think it was about 3 a.m. We'd been waiting all afternoon, evening. Very cold night, and the back lot of Pinewood Studios in England, which happens to be on top of an underground lake, so the floor, the ground is icy cold. Richard Lester said, okay, sir, you come in, you walk up to that bit of wood, you stuff the bit of wood, you catch the manhole cover in your hand, you throw it, you toss it, and you hit Superman, and he did it, boom, 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 boom. And I remember thinking, sounds rather difficult, But his approach was very calculating and rather cold, and I responded very well to it. So I thought, oh, okay. There was no... It doesn't matter, it might be difficult, whatever. His approach was, this is what you're going to do. And lo and behold, that's exactly what I did. I was able to go straight up to this developer. And indeed afterwards, so I think it was just after that, when I threw the bus across the street, I still got a back injury, still got a shoulder, very bad shoulder injury from throwing the bus. Because I lifted the bus on the chain, and he said, you go up to the bus, you pick it up, and you lift it, and you're going to throw it across the street. And the bus was on a crane with a big chain, obviously. And so as you're lifting it, they're lifting it. But what I didn't count on was, as they lifted it, there's a fraction of settlement, and it's a real bus. Mm-hmm. So as I'm lifting it, and the crane is lifting the bus up, of course it moves fractionally, and I go on holding it. Instead of relaxing my arms, I go on having superpowers. So of course I rip all my back very, very badly. And afterwards he said, Lester, why didn't you relax your arms? And I said, for those few minutes, I had superpowers.
Right.
For those few seconds, when you're in, as they say in acting, when you're in the moment, which is not something that my breed of actors necessarily use that terminology, but when you're actually in character, it's not about a moment, so it's about being in character the whole time. You have superpowers.
Right.
So, big difference between the two directors.
Okay. I didn't realize that you'd suffered an injury like that. So.
I have 9 separate injuries. And a settlement from the producers.
Oh, okay.
At the end of it all, because it screwed me up, very much so. And has continued to. Abnormal injuries from doing abnormal things, but it's all worth it.
Right. Now, fast forwarding a little bit to another movie, the second Conan movie that you did with Arnold and Grace Jones and everyone. Just tell us a little bit about that, them working on that project as well.
Well, it's... he's the governor, and he was and still is a lot of fun. So with Arnold, and in those days you couldn't really understand what he was saying.
Right.
He speaks a lot better now, but he was really it was really a fun project to be on. I was also shooting Falcon Crest at the same time, So I would have to, I did 3 days on Falcon Crest, then I would fly down to Mexico and do 4 days down in Mexico, and then I would fly back to do another episode of Falcon Crest. And it was in the days when I thought this was what it was going to be like the rest of my life. It was so crazy with work back and forth. So going down to Mexico was a great adventure for me. And Will Chamberlain, who was brilliant, and Grace Jones, I mean, it was early 80s, mid 80s. Mm-hmm. And for anybody in my age group that remembers the 80s, or is it my age group, they wouldn't remember it, they know that there was a pretty fun time to be around. And we all enjoyed a pretty good time.
Right.
So there was a lot of fun on the set, lots of, it was very, very good. And I think Arnold was, you know, he travels, he still has the same group of friends that he worked with then are still around him now. So he's very secure wherever he is. And we had really good experiences. I know that Grace had never ridden a horse before, so they put her on the back, on, you know, first time on a horse. Or she barely had ridden a horse, you know, she just clung on and did like, I ride and I've had horses, so I enjoyed my experiences there. But I was clad head to toe in leather, and it was Mexico, so it was very bloody hot.
Right.
But it was fun. Xcon was good. I loved it.
Now the current popular TV series is Smallville, mm-hmm. and you know they've had a lot of the previous alumni members have been on there, like Mark McClure's mm-hmm. been on there, Chris and Margo. Do you have any interest if they were to approach you to be on the series as well?
The Smallville producers by now would have been inundated 2 million times with requests from my agent and myself. Mm-hmm. I can say right here from the very first episode of Smallville. Right back then, when I saw it, I went straight home and I called my agent and said, this is a fabulous thing, let's try and get me a meeting. And he contacted the producers, and we've gone on contacting the producers. And there are Facebook fan sites, Get Sarah on Smallville.
Right.
There are people writing letters. And just last week, I was in Los Angeles, and I said to my agent, and he said, don't say it. And I said, but what is, this is becoming, I'm beginning to get embarrassed about it. Aside from the fact, what I'd really like to do is, I'd love to be on Smallville. I'd love to be in the background, you know, serving French fries. I don't care what I'm doing, but I'd love to be associated for a brief moment in time with Smallville. And I'm almost taking it personally. So if there's anything that you, in your infinite wisdom, can do for me in terms of letting them know, because it is... quite staggering. On a daily basis, I'm getting emails. Whenever I come to a convention, all the fans say, why aren't you on Smallville? And I'm beginning to sort of get slightly embarrassed, and I think we've only got this season, and that's it, isn't it?
That's what they're saying, but now lately they've been hinting at, you know, never say never from 11.
Well, never say never. Never say never to Sarah Douglas, because I don't understand it, and I have made myself more than willing and able, and I said, I will come in and just have an interview. You know, I'll just come in and talk to you, come in and interview. I don't... You know, I'll do anything it takes, and I'm beginning to take it rather personally. And I don't think I've offended anybody over there.
No. I couldn't see why.
No. I don't. Yeah. I'm being, you know, I'm saying it slightly tongue in cheek. It is a mystery to me, and I'm really. It would be the biggest thrill. It would be a bloody thrill if they even said, "Come on in and have a chat with us." Don't understand it. So get your all your lovely people that
well, everybody
on your side
that sees the interview. Yeah. Here, they have
that whole, would you do that for me? I want to be on Smallville. I'll serve French fries, anything. But come on, guys, what's with you? It's embarrassing. It is. It's embarrassing.
Well, I'm glad it's good to know that you're interested in being
on. Of course, that's the most embarrassing thing that all my fans are saying to me. Why aren't you doing Smallville? Mm-hmm. I go, why aren't I? Why aren't I?
Right.
I don't know why. And I've actually. I've got one or two really good contacts. I met the young lady, delightful young lady, last year in Birmingham in England, who was staring at me, and then she said, I kind of play you on Smallville. What would her name be? She's the young, her character, she looked at a lot of footage of Superman, of Ursa.
Okay.
She's on Smallville, she's an actress, she plays a baddie girl.
Okay. I'm not sure which one that could be.
Well, she was. They told her to look at Ursa, and she did. She's kind of playing. Because okay. She said to me, "You could play my mom."
Okay.
Yeah, okay. I could play a grandmom, I don't care. But she plays a character that is based on, or she has based on, Ursa. She's not called Ursa.
It's probably Tess Mercer, the character Tess Mercer. She's the one that took over from when they technically killed off Lex 2 seasons ago.
Oh, really?
And now she was like the main bad person, but now she's kind of become more of a good person.
So. I see, it's a problem. You see, this keeps happening to me. I start off bad, but I'm so sweet, I end up good. Okay.
Okay. Well, I appreciate you taking the time.
I'm delighted to. I have to go back to doing my stuff. But thank you very much. Right. I will look forward to looking at your site. Tell me again.
SupermanSupersite.com.
SupermanSupersite.com. Okay.
Thank you
very much. Okay. Thank you.